Former Philippine Vice President Lenny Robredo meets with former Senator Leila De Lima days after De Lima's release from detention. Jose Carretero reports.
It was a busy day for former Senator Leila De Lima back in her hometown in Iriga City. She continues to receive a steady flow of supporters who wish to see her personally and to extend their well wishes. After a quick chat with her visitors, De Lima visited an orphanage and school in Iriga City where her aunt is an administrator. From there, she went to the Our Lady of Fatima Catholic Cemetery to visit the graves of her father and other relatives.
Baski sa kulungan, lagi akong kinakausap ko talaga siya. Lagi ko si Daddy naman, tulungan niyo ako na makalaya na. So now that I'm here, hindi pwedeng hindi ko siya mabisita sa tomb.
Her next stop, Naga City, to meet former Vice President Lenny Robredo. They talked for nearly 2 hours, but they didn't touch on politics.
Wala kami pinag-usapan na politika. Actually, halos lahat personal. Kung nakapaglinis na ba siya ng bahay, kung naayos niya na ba yung kanyang mga gamit, ano yung mga gagawin in the next few days. Talagang lahat personal.
Tinanong niya ako yung ano, mga plano ko. Sabi ko, ayusin ko muna syempre yung buhay ko and then marami akong iaano muna, mga ayusin niya, mga dokumento, mga kung ano-ano, pagbalik ko sa Manila.
Robredo said, politics can wait.
Sa tingin ko, she deserves na bigyan muna ng panahon na yung personal affairs niya, ayusin niya. Bago pa man isipin yung mga next steps for the opposition or next steps for the party, mahabang panahon yung ika-catch up niya para sa sarili niya.
In the meantime, the former senator said she's open to cooperating with the International Criminal Court on its investigation into Duterte's deadly drug war.
Dati ko naman talagang iniisip yan. In whatever capacity, kung ano pa man ang pwedeng gawin na makatulong sa investigasyon ng ICC. Although ongoing na nga yan. Yes, I'm very much willing. Kasi after all, sinimulan ko naman talaga yung mga investigation na yan, even from the CHR and then especially sa Senate. Kaya lang hindi ko naman talaga mga natapos, especially sa Senate, since I was ousted as a chair of the committee.
Ako magharap ng ICC. Ang ICC ang magharap sa akin dito. Lekturan ko sila ng international law. Bakit ako magharap ng mga judges na puti o itim dyan? Ano ka? Siniswerto kayo? I'm not even opposing it. Go ahead. Come.
De Lima walked free on Monday after being allowed to post bail after nearly 7 years in detention in what her camp insists are trumped-up drug charges. Jose Carretero, ABS-CBN News.
Philippine House Deputy Majority Leader Erwin Tulfo maintains there are no impeachment talks against Vice President Sara Duterte at the lower chamber. Teachers Party List Representative Franz Castro earlier claimed congressmen have been plotting to remove Vice President Duterte from her position. But Tulfo says House leaders, including Speaker Martin Romualdez himself, have all denied the existence of such a plan. Tulfo also believes that even if there were a plot to oust the Vice President, it would not be successful.
I believe I was thinking about it last night because of the CIF siguro. Will that hold? Right now, what we're looking, it will not gain something. You have to have a violation of the Constitution, graft and corruption, treason, and then high crimes. And lastly, lose the public trust. Wala tayong nakikitang ganon versus VP Sara Duterte. She's still very popular.
Tulfo also joins House leaders in denying rumors that Speaker Romualdez is planning to run for president in the 2028 election. His remarks came after former President Rodrigo Duterte claimed the Speaker is positioning himself as a presidential candidate. This has sparked speculations. Romualdez wants to take Vice President Duterte out as a potential presidential rival.
I've been in Congress for about 4 months now. Since nang tumuntong ako, and then I was appointed as the majority, deputy majority for communications, walang napapag-usapan on the table, kahit na on the side among sa his ikang advisors, house leadership, kahit yung mga minority leaders. Wala naman ako naririnig na may plano sa speaker to run versus Sara Duterte, VP Sara Duterte. So I don't know kung saan ang galing, kung saan nakuha ni former president.
The word war between former President Rodrigo Duterte and House Minority Leader Franz Castro continues. Castro says Duterte is making fun of her grave threats complaint, calling it a blatant disrespect of the Philippine justice system. This after Duterte said he will just go to jail when asked about his response to the complaint. He also accused Castro yet again of being a Communist Party member. Now, Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla slams a UN official for recommending the abolition of the country's anti-communist task force. United Nations expert Ian Fry condemned the agency for its red-tagging activities, saying it is already operating beyond its mandate. But for Remulla, the UN rapporteur should not tell the Philippine government what to do. He adds Fry should not interfere in the matter since it's an internal mechanism of the Philippine government. A Philippine police officer faces charges over his extramarital affair with a beauty pageant contestant who has been missing for over a month now. Jeff Caparaz has details.
Police Major Alan De Castro is facing a complaint for conduct unbecoming of a police officer for engaging in extramarital affairs. De Castro admitted that he had a romantic relationship with the missing beauty pageant bet, Catherine Camilon. According to the PNP Internal Affairs Service, they will soon issue a recommendation on the complaint.
Chinacharge namin siya ng conduct unbecoming of a police officer. So, bago mag-end po yung November, maglabas na po kami ng recommendation. Kasi yun po yun aming time frame sa pagposisyon ng kaso na yun.
De Castro, his driver Jeffrey Magpantay, and two John Does have been tagged as suspects in Camilon's disappearance. Complaints of kidnapping and serious illegal detention have been filed at the Batangas Prosecutor's Office. De Castro has been asked to file his counter-affidavit. If dismissed, De Castro will lose all his benefits and will be barred from government service. The Criminal Investigation and Detection Group is still looking for two unidentified suspects whom witnesses saw carrying a bloodied woman, believed to be the missing 26-year-old.
Doon po sa statement ng dalawang witness natin, ito po yung nagbuhat mismo doon sa dugo ang babae. Yung na-identify po na nagmamando at tumutok ng baril, ay ito po yung si Jeffrey Magpantay. Ito po yung based on our research, ay personal driver ni Major Alan De Castro. Meron kaming ongoing intelligence work. Yun nga ang objective natin, ma-strengthen yung kaso natin at aminin namin na hindi pa namin nabuo yung sequence of events.
Authorities feared the worst, but Camilon's mother Rose is still holding out hope her daughter will return home.
Kahit po medyo ganyan yung mga nalabas na balita, ganyan yung naririnig at nakikita namin na ganyan yung mga masasamang balita, sa puso ko, ramdam ko naman ho na nandyan lang siya
Yun.
Ramdam ko ho, at hindi ko ho talaga isinasa puso na siya wala na.
The result of the DNA profiling on the hair strands and suspected blood samples retrieved from the abandoned vehicle believed to be involved in the incident is expected to be released this week.
Kung ma-prove po yung mga hair strands at saka mga blood samples po ay magmamatch po yon doon sa DNA po ng mga magulang po at kaanak po ni Miss Catherine, then that would definitely give more credence po doon sa ating jury na itong nakita po ng dalawang witness po natin na isang babaeng duguan na nilipat mula doon po sa Nissan Juke na positively identified po nila na the same Nissan Juke na gamit po ng ating biktima.
De Castro is in restrictive custody at CAF Vicente Lim in Laguna, while his personal driver Magpantay is the subject of a manhunt. Jeff Caparaz, ABS-CBN News.